Unculturally, it has been 6 months since I arrived in China. From Kuala Lumpur to Guangzhou, from tropical climate to temperate climate. For some reason, living in this city always made me feel lost and confused. In Malaysia, I have never experienced such a heavy place before. The heavy burden of economy was the anxiety of life and the uncertain future often leave me feeling overwhelmed. I am desperate to find a way out of this problem. Until a chance, under the inculcation of teacher, I learned about a village called Yinlin. The teacher told me that in fact, in China, there is not only urban civilization, but also a rich and colorful village culture. I decided to visit Yinlin Village and look for different possibilities of life. My name is Tan Jiunn Wei. This is my story. Yinlin Village, located in Taiping of Chonghua in Guangzhou. A hilly area, 18 kilometers away from the center of Guangzhou. The village is surrounded by beautiful village scenery with unique farm and home scattered around. The view is a sky and the people are kind and skilled. In recent years, dozens of new villagers have settled down in Yinlin Village. They are left behind the noise of the city, crying out a lifestyle that is half farming and half sustainable. Most of them are working in the ecological farm, plucking the grains and green crops, fishing and enjoying tea, like living in the hidden paradise. Together they would travel on a boat with billowed sail. Jackie kept a lookout perched on Puff's gigantic tail. The action showed me in Yinlin Village, life is their main priority, no matter how they earn a living. The first person I met here was Gore. He was one of the first new villagers, also the owner of the Yinlin Ecological Farm. From him, I seem to see the many different possibilities as an ordinary person. Jiunn, as Gory called her, was the second new villager I met on Yinlin Village. Her experience of feeling stressed in the city life resonated with me deeply. I began to wonder if I also can find a sense of belonging here.
I 在北京实习，这个地方它竟然云集了中国可能最强、最厉害、收入最高的一群人，但是他们每天就跟沙丁鱼一样，然后鱼贯而出，鱼贯而回。那你就想，我为什么？
Children on the farm also reminded me of my mom and childhood. The freedom and tranquility of the village helped me feel the comfort and relaxation, which I had long missed. Later, I know Peng Cheng, who the founder of the village, and Shui Shui, a single mother. They are connected with the nature in this land, with their beloved children, like a cast of freshness and movement in the pond. Xiaoqing, who won a guava farm on his own, was the most memorable person on this trip. In just a few days of being together, he helped me untie the sad knot in my heart.
我是园艺专业毕业的，毕业后就来到银林村从事生态农业。我以前在深圳上学，我在大学的时候就有段时间就感觉比较抑郁，城市里很多东西在限制到我。气场，就当这气场它散发不掉的时候，比如说我们在地铁里、在公交车上扩散不出去的时候，就会感觉到压抑。村里这种很大的环境里面，它气场可以释放出来。村里生活四年嘛，现在就非常享受现在的工作状态、生活状态。此心安处是吾乡，不管在哪里，这颗心安定的地方，我们都可以把自己作为故乡。我觉得我也可以把这句话送给你。就不管你未来在中国是再待半年，还是想要长期的定居，如果你能把自己的心安定下来的话，可以把自己当成故乡一样去相处。
小青 show me a simple and poetic way of living. Choose to live in harmony with nature. He told me that when you return to the land and it expires,Life offers new opportunity. But it wasn't until Xiaoqing's words that I finally understood. Just like leaf falling without any orders, the world is not bound by any other truth. The basket city life and the right way of life wasn't really important.Where our heart finds solace and serenity is where we truly belong.
我带着比山地重的行李，犹如你落后。
When I come to Chonghua, when I come to Yinlin Village, I realize everyone is imperfect, just in different way. Just like I have been struggling for stuttering since I was a child, my speech has always unclear.For 20 years, I unconsciously avoid talking to others and avoiding medical treatment. But now, I understand that following your heart flees from other gates, and in fact, this is the truth of life. Thanks for the new villagers and his beautiful village. As Kushu saying goes, the place of Lingang shouldn't be great. Where the heart is contained, home is where the heart is.
我记得这里是片树林，后面有个山坡，山坡上的枣树，每当秋天到来，我们把枣装满口袋。我记得除了朋友，我还坐过你的舒服，你总喜欢跟在我的屁股后面，只是为了那几个铜钱。我记得我们曾是恋人，战争爆发，你上战场后就再也没有回来，直到收不到你的信。我们总这样重复翻译，却要重新开始，相互送给对方，说着来世再见，再次失意着相聚。Thank you.